Now, I received a new cartridge for the Telefunken in the mail today, and it works all right. One thing I wanted to point out here. Now, and I found these for sale other places from where I bought it. They all use the same stock photo. It appears that these are actually made in China. I don't know who's making cartridges in China, but, you know, it was either that, getting this, or a new old stock, you know, cartridge that might have the same crumbling suspension as I'm sure, some of y'all have been down this road before. I know I have, especially with old Sonatone cartridges. But anyhow, well, I wanted to listen to a 78 here, just to try it out. And the new cartridge is just double-sided, you know, LP stylus. So I wanted to switch the stylus off the old cartridge onto here temporarily, just to play a 78. Well, you can see, if you look, let me get something to point with. Try to adjust the light. If you see through this area here, you see the tabs are very, you know, well, the gap is a lot wider. You can see the end of it here. They got a little pivot on the back that sticks through the back, and this snaps in. And then there's a little snap, you know, that this whole little, you know, slot goes into, you know, it holds it in place. Well, you can easily just slide this one forward and pop the stylus out. When I attempted to do that with this one, it slid forward, and then you can see how much closer the gaps are. I mean, you pretty much are going to destroy the stylus if you try to take it out of here. When I went to push it back, and I don't know if this is going to show up, but you see that little white line right there? That's actually a stress mark where the flipper started to crack off of the body. And I was lucky enough to get it back in the hole and get it back in place, but I guarantee you, if I flip this thing over a couple of times, it's just going to break right off of here. So that's your quality of the stuff made in China today. You know, meanwhile, if the suspension wouldn't have fallen apart on this cartridge, I would have ordered a $4 stylus for it and been done with it. You know, this is the original Telefunken cartridge. T23, made in Western Germany, and it's a shame the suspension fell apart, but of course there's no brand markings on this one. Now, one thing I thought about doing, and if these things weren't so expensive, I would seriously consider it, because, I mean, this new one from China cost me $24.95. You know, if these were a little more reasonable, I would order another one and experiment with opening the body of the cartridge up. Because it looks like you can pull back on these tabs. You can see this one isn't even seated correctly on this side. It looks like you can get the lid off of here. It looks like you could get the lid off. You know, I've never opened up a cartridge before, really. I mean, but I would be interested in trying to take a good suspension out of one of these reproductions or something else and putting one back in this Telefunken cartridge, if that would be possible. I'm going to try to look into doing that. I know I have some, and they're new old stock, you know, so they might have the same problems. I've got a box of old cartridges around that don't fit anything that I have, and I might try doing that, because obviously the quality of this is crap, and it even makes me wonder, you know, you can buy these replacement styluses, but if I have to replace the stylus on this, you know, am I going to break the new one trying to get it in through these tabs here? I mean, it's, you know, for $25, you know, you ought to get a little better than that. You know, if I had paid, you know, $5 or $6 for this thing, I would say, oh well, you know, you buy a whole nother unit, you know, it just goes along with the territory. But well, that's where we're at with that. So be wary of Chinese replacement cartridges. Now let's show it in operation. Let's see what it's going to do with a 10-inch. I haven't tried this yet. Now let's watch the Chinese stylus carve itself into the record. Well, it's got it in the right place. Obviously, these Chinese needles are so cheap that, I mean, I realized that it was the smaller one, but I've never had this happen before. It ate. So you hear all this? Watch when it gets off the section that I played. Now, yeah, I realize it was the wrong stylus to use on, but I've never had that happen before. I'd run old BSRs, you know, and, you know, with the wrong needles. It's never damaged one of these. And I'm just a little beside myself right now. Now I'm kind of wondering, because I played a couple of my records out of my jukebox that I put in storage. I played a couple of them tonight. Now I'm wondering if it screwed them up. I'm going to play the B-side of this Bee Gees record that I never play. It really didn't do anything that happened. Alright, so I'll show you what it does with a 45. And it puts it in the right place. know my problem with all of this is that I fixed this unit up to use in the room where I have my records, all of my records stored now, and over at Mama's house, because there wasn't a lot of room for anything bigger than this, and that's why I pulled this one out and did all the work to it. And now, you know, I'm really going to be hesitant to play a lot of my better records on this thing, where, you know, on a normal console, even with a ceramic cartridge, I wouldn't think too much about it. You know, and I hate to go through modifying the son of a bitch for a magnetic cartridge, but either find something else to use, or I don't know. I mean, I've got time to get something ready for over there, but it's just aggravating, you know? Especially if it's spending $25 on this damn thing. Looking through the camera here. Well, shit on it. I guess I've screwed up enough shit tonight. What the hell? Anyhow, usual trip. There's something I'm curious about. Where did the changer spindle go? Let's see. Put that down in here. Yeah. I haven't tried the changer spindle since I got all the mechanics working back in this thing again. It wasn't working before at all. Umbrella type, no overarm or anything. Well, let's see what happens. Ah, it works now. I like that. Yes, Not happy with the Chinese needle situation. But I guess that, you know, maybe when they cut into this old record, maybe when I do play it with a 3mm stylus, I won't hear it. It's kind of aggravating, because it's not exactly something very common. It's just I happen to see it laying there, and I grabbed it. Fuel Firehouse 5 plus 2. Good Time Jazz, number 52, out of Los Angeles. Mississippi rag on the backside. I've never even cleaned this thing. Yep. So, guess we live and we learn. But, mechanically, mechanically she's working. The only thing I have left to do to it is re-lube the motor itself. But I mean, everything else in this thing has been cleaned and redone. So, this is probably the last update on here. We'll pull something else out soon. I gotta look at this dual 1009F that was my brother's. It was mine years ago. And, I gave it to him probably just about 10 years ago when I bought my project. And he said it was doing something. He said something wasn't exactly quite working right with it. You know, and then he passed away, so I'll just have to plug it up and investigate it and see what's going on. I know one thing, the darn cabinet came unglued in the corner when I went to move it, so I'm going to have to re-glue the cabinet back together. But that's a pretty good old turntable there. I used it for a long time. I think I bought it for $10, and it included an old 60s Scott receiver that had a dead channel. So the receiver couldn't be fixed back then, but, you know, I'm not going to pick up one of these for $10 anymore. Well, all right.